Hey there, StarCraft fans. Welcome back. This is Lasercorn with Mahalo Video Games. Today we've got TT1 against Liquid Jinro on Zelnaga Caverns. This is the MLG Championship round, final round at the MLG 2010 in Dallas. And this just happened today, so we're casting it as soon as it happens, bringing it to you as fast as you can. Maybe you saw this streaming through the MLG channel and want to see a replay, or maybe you're just a diehard fan who missed this game and wants to see what shook out in the finals, but we're checking it out. We're checking it out together because I have not seen this yet. I missed the stream, but MLG was nice enough to provide replays for us on their website, so good guys. Although, yeah, good guys. They came through even though Blizzard's Battle.net went down for a little bit from what I'm hearing news reports out of there. Good, let me get production on. Good support for incorporating land play into maybe a future patch or something. But from all reports coming out of BlizzCon, Blizzard has no intention of doing that, sadly. So us StarCraft fans will just have to reminisce nostalgically about the days when we played Brood War via LAN. And cry a little. No, it's not that sad. Battle.net's mostly reliable. Every now and then it doesn't want to let you play, but, you know, nothing's perfect. Looks like we got TT1 Chrono boosting some probes. This is game two in the series between these two players. And here comes Jinro's scouting CV to see what's up here. Gonna get a good look at TT1's base, but TT1 gonna get a good look at Jinro's base. Even though he's gonna be chased off by this Marine who, wow, almost looked like he was shooting and running there for a second. That was weird. And the probe gonna get away on his propulsion jet system thing that he has. I don't know if the Marine's still looking for him, but the probe has gone the other direction. And we got a fun little game of hide and seek going on in Zelnaga Caverns. I think there's another Marine on the ramp. Uh-oh, run probe. Does this probe have the moves to get back in the base and get additional scouting info? My instincts say yes. My instincts are correct. Probes are hard to catch, man. You better be careful there. There's a Marauder coming out. Oh, and those Marines are coming back in the base to deal with this obnoxious little fella. There's the Marauder now, and that probe's going down. Nothing he can do about it. Anyway, still the probe is gone to throw down this command center. He's expanding pretty quickly. If TT1 gets wind of this, quick Jinro expansion, it could be trouble for Jinro. Jinro may be getting a little cocky here, having made his way all the way up through the winner's bracket without suffering any losses. Got a probe coming out though, and it's going to get an expansion too. So we're going to see both players grabbing their naturals around Zelnaga Caverns. Here comes a small Marine Marauder detachment. Gonna come hang out, see what's going on. How are we doing on that command center? Almost done. We've got Stimpaks researching. Another Marauder coming out. Meanwhile, Stalkers for TT1. Command center's done. I can only imagine he's going to lift off and float to his natural. Yes, he is. Meanwhile, Rock's being broken down here. Thinking ahead. Jinro maybe wants that. It'd be nice to have those rocks destroyed if he so chooses to put up a gold expansion. TT1 just about done with his expansion as well. That blue Stargate-esque flash you see right before it comes in. Kind of cool. You got a command center morphing into an orbital command. Poor planetary fortresses. They don't get any use at this high level of play. Maybe to hold a cool expansion. And another probe getting in here. Wow, these probes are very heroic. Willing to sacrifice their lives. Just to see what's going on in the base. Oh, Jinro. Jinro got a reactor and a tech lab out on these. And he's pure infantry right now. I don't see a starport or a factory coming up. I guess it would be factory, then starport. Marine shields, though, coming out. And I think we already have, yes, concussive shells and stim packs. So these infantries have about all the optional upgrades and cool fly accessories that you can have. They're pimped out, as some would say. Not a lot on the production tab for TT1. He is throwing down a robotics facility. And realizing there's an SCV in his midst. Wow, we got like, it's like a 4-gate here. But now he's kind of transitioning into robotics facilities before any major conflicts occurred. And he supply capped himself. So he's gonna have to wait on this probe. Makes me feel better whenever I see a probe get supply capped. Makes me feel not so bad about myself when I'm forget to build a supply depot. While those mules going to work for Jinro, boosting his economy up a little bit over the economy of TT1. And we got a probe sneaking through the back corridors of Zelnaga Cavern. He's got a pylon back there to watch from any sneaky play. Sometimes Terrans will love to stim up Marines and Marauders and run right into your mineral line, which is no fun for a Protoss player,
or a Zerg player,
or even another Terran player. So, wise decision putting that pylon out there. Got a bunker watching this expansion. Two more gases coming down. What does he need all that gas for? Looks like we're gonna have a dropship, a medvac. That's from my Brood War days coming out. And the only real action so far has been seen by SCVs and probes as they try and break into enemy bases. Here comes a Marine though, shield in hand, to see if there's an expansion up here. There is not. Here we go. Marauders, Marines, and a Ghost moving out. Ghost has snipe. Come on, nukes. Come on, Jinro. You're way ahead. Throw a nuke down on the production tab. Why do pros hate nukes? I think I saw TLO use some once. Colossus on the field now, and that extended thermal lance upgrade coming out. Make the Colossus very deadly. Marauders, though, can stim up and snipe out a Colossus pretty quickly, so we'll have to see what happens. Oh, and he finds the Proxy Pylon. Proxy Pylon is done for. But it did give TT1 a look at that, the makeup of this Terran army. EMP round for the Ghost now available. So shields on those Colossus are going to go down. And look at this. TT1 has run into that pylon, which did exactly what it was supposed to do, which is alert TT1 to the fact that there are Marines and Marauders back here in this corridor, and scares them off with a Stalker. Well, basically by bringing his whole army back there. And he's going to throw it on another pylon. So good play by TT1, setting up that early warning system, giving himself an advanced notice of what was about to happen. It looks like we're going to have a drop coming out for Jinro. And that medbag just skirts around this army. Dangerously close. And look at this, the command center floating in, but this large TT1 force also coming in, and some of General forces are away in that dropship, and here we go. We are going to have an engagement. Force fields and guardian shields going down. Wow, those Vikings really doing a lot of damage, already taking down the Colossi. And it looks like Jinro going to be forced to retreat. Oh, getting a few Vikings sniped out there. Meanwhile, we've got a drop going on back here. A small contingent for Jinro trying to do some damage to the Protoss base. And oh, this command center gets caught back behind enemy lines. Jinro forced to sacrifice that command center. He cannot be feeling good about that. That's a hit no matter how you look at it. And now he's going to try and get a little revenge back here in the base. But here comes that Colossus. And these troops are going to have to evacuate quickly. The sooner the better. Oh, one guy getting left behind to burn to that Colossus. TT1 not playing around anymore. Oh, shoot. Except he left the Colossus way out of position. Oh, TT1, you can't be losing units like that. Although he did manage to take a command center off of Jinro, so I don't think it's too uneven. 161 supply for TT1, and we're looking at 149 for Jinro. But Jinro making a beeline for that expansion of TT1. And not only that, he's got that harassing, annoying drop force back there too. Looks like he's going to pull his main force back and his drop force while TT1 tries to hunt down this rogue army of Jinro. And this Viking gonna just barely survive. Look at how quick those stalkers are taking pot shots. Oh, and we've got a Colossus on the high ground. Wow, these units are really gonna have to decide. Okay, Vikings going after the Colossus, and Guardian Shield is up, and this Jinro army getting obliterated here with support from this stalker. And wow, they are all going down. They are stimming up, running backwards, trying to get away, but it's not going to be enough. That Immortal hunting them. And where is the rest of TT1's army going? You can't leave. Well, I guess he had it under control. You don't want to leave your Immortals out there like that. And there's that drop force again. Man, that's got to be annoying. Every time there's a main battle going on, there's a drop force harassing TT1. What do we got here? 153 supply against 115. Oh my goodness, Jinro is in trouble. I guess in terms of the tournament, though, he's not really in trouble because he's in that winner's bracket. He's got a lot of confidence going for him, but uh-oh, here comes this TT1 force, and they're just going to plow through what's standing here. Man, if that bunker could have got up, he might have stood a chance, but I don't think he can now. Planetary Fortress trying to morph in, and a Colossus going down, getting sniped out by those Vikings, but only one Viking left in the air now, and Jinro pulling back as much as he can. He's going to have to re-engage here once his Planetary Fortress finishes. He needs to cancel that Planetary Fortress. And I don't know if he canceled in time, but GG from Liquid Jinro. Wow. That was an intense match. And wow. Yeah, Jinro hasn't lost a lot during this tournament, I don't think. So he's kind of caught off guard there. But a victory for TT1 on Zelnaga Caverns. Hey guys, what's up? This is Lasercorn. I just want to remind you to subscribe, comment, and rate these videos. Also, if you have any requests for videos you want to see or just want to say what's up, send that over to requests@mahalo.com. All right, thanks a lot, guys.